if you were an 18-year-old planning your career, going into university, what would you study or what would you skill yourself with to prepare for this new world that's coming?
That's a question I'm often asked by parents. I'm a parent. I have an 18-year-old.
Oh, okay. What is the advice that you're giving your own child then?
Well, that particular child has their own mind, so it doesn't actually matter.
Like AI.
It doesn't matter what advice I give. And he wants to be a creative writer, and I think there are risks even in that profession,
yes,
because AI systems seem to be able to be, you know, at least for derivative writing,
yes,
pastiche writing and so on, they're excellent. So my sense is that if you think 20 or 30 years in the future, and we assume that progress in AI continues, one would expect that a very large number of jobs will be of an interpersonal nature,
mm-hmm,
for two reasons. One is that humans have a built-in advantage due to the fact we're human. We know what it's like to be a human, and we can put ourselves in the situation of another and feel. You know, I often give the example, well, if you don't know what it's like to hit your thumb with a hammer, you can find out, right? You can just hit your thumb with a hammer and say, ah, now I get it, right? And that's a very specific feeling, and you can experience it,
right,
and one assumes that the other person is experiencing it in the same way. And so that's something that isn't available to machines. So there's a built-in advantage that we have. Plus, for many interpersonal roles, we actually want a human to do it.
Mm-hmm.
If you think about a profession of, you know, a professional luncher, right? So someone who goes to lunch with you and you have a really interesting conversation and you learn about food and wine and you go away feeling inspired or whatever, right? That would be an interesting profession, but it's probably not going to work if it's a machine on the other side of the table. So I'm sort of making light of it, but this is a really serious issue because, as Lauren said, how do governments invest? How do our education systems have to change? For those types of interpersonal professions to be successful, they've got to be based on real understanding. Just as medicine is based on real understanding of the human body that we've developed by investing in medical research, it's the largest area of research in the world. And we've invested trillions of dollars over hundreds of years to get to the point where I can, if I break my leg, I have a good chance of getting it fixed as opposed to dying of gangrene. And that's great, and we are willing to pay surgeons accordingly. But we don't pay childcare. We don't pay for childcare at anything like the rate we pay for surgery. Why is that? Our children are really important to us.
Mm-hmm.
And the answer is because there's no scientific basis and there's no professional training that with high probability will give good outcomes from childcare.
I'm going to push you back a little bit on interpersonal skills,
yeah,
right? Because now this is really worrying me. The Corona generation, which is kind of the teenagers which are coming into university education now, do not really have interpersonal skills. That's one of the things that social media has deprived them of. They are used to being filtered, and they are very good on text, and they are excellent in digital scenarios,
yeah,
but in person, they find it really difficult, you know. Even dating is a problem. Online texting, fine, flirting with someone, but meeting in person is a,
yes,
problem. So then we're really in trouble. What we need is interpersonal skills because that's what's going to save us. And that's the one skill we're losing because of social media. How are we going to marry these two?
So I think we're actually going to have to create social environments where these skills can be acquired. You know, and I think to some extent that's one of the functions of universities, is a place where people go from being children to being sufficiently grown up that they can function well in the real world, that they can come to a place like Davos and sit in a shuttle bus and meet all the other people, and by the end of a 20-minute ride, they've got 10 new friends, right? Those are important skills, and looking forward, it'll actually be much more professionalized, one assumes.
Hmm.
And you think about professions now that are emerging, like executive coach. This is becoming a thing, right? I get all these connections on LinkedIn from people who have titles like executive coach,
life coach,
life skills trainer, blah, 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 right? So it's happening. But none of those people, I talked to some just the other day, none of those people have PhDs in executive coaching because there aren't any PhDs in executive coaching because there's no science of how to do it. And it takes decades to develop the science, the professionalization, the training, the education programs, all of that. And we probably need to start now. The understanding that most governments have is, oh, we need more STEM, science, technology, engineering, mathematics, medicine. That probably may be true in the short term, but even computer programmers are being threatened by AI systems because for many routine applications, they're able to just write the programs with no help from the human.